As app developers, it's our job to maintain the illusion that once started, every app is waiting patiently in the background, looking for its chance to be the star when called on. So whenever the user switches back to your app, whether or not the system has killed it in the interim, they should be presented with the same UI they had when they left. To help, Android has a pair of handlers specifically for persisting state in these circumstances. OnSave instance state is called immediately before onPause. So as soon as your app is no longer active, and onRestore instance state is called immediately after onCreate, but only if the app is being restarted after having been terminated by the system. That means you can read the bundle of state information saved the last time your app was moved from the foreground here. The next time your user switches to your app, even if it was killed by the system in the meantime. Using that bundle, you can return your UI to the same state it was the last time the user saw it, creating a seamless transition that hides the resource management happening under the covers. But that's enough of the why. Let's go back to Dan and see how to put this theory into practice.